Hello everyone and welcome to finally a new part for how to win as the Predator in Predator Hunting Grounds. Today we have the scout and we are running the bow, the smart disc, a healing kit with motion detectors, and our perks are long jump, adrenal boost and impatient. So with Adrenal Boost and Long Jump, we will be able to move with the scout very fast across the entire map with ease, and Impatient will help us with our second wind recovery. So if we get shot into second wind, we will get it back pretty quickly. And the reason why this video took me so long was mostly because out of this. Okay, they are over there, and they have a pick here. Let's get the... Oh no. The game froze. The game crashes, wow. I waited 6 minutes. And that really annoys me, but anyways, I have two builds actually. With the first I kinda suck, as you will see very soon, because my aim was kinda bad at that point. I really sucked with my bow aim at that point, but... I made a second build. I will put a timestamp in the video right now so that you can skip to that if you rather would want something where you don't have to use the bow. And I managed to actually win with that build. The problem with Scout is, as you will see in this little gameplay, I will kinda lose actually here. Mostly because not just my aim sucks, but the biggest problem I had was that this fire team was pretty good actually. They could parry my wrist blades if I would go into melee, and they were actually kinda hunting me at one point. And against a good fire team, you won't be able to win with a scout. That's a fact. It's just not possible. It just is not possible to win with the scout against a really good coordinated fire team that is in the party chat, because the fire team is just completely unbalanced and OP. What I did here, I was looking for the respawn radio, because with scout you don't really want them to respawn. So looking for that is pretty important. I did here a little mistake, the reason I put this loss, and this was also the first match of the day for me with Predator, that I accidentally somehow switched to the plasma caster, I don't know. Thought I had my markers out, but apparently not. So a mistake I did there was I didn't vent to the medic kit, because at my left there's this small hole. Ray building thing, and there's a medikit, and you should destroy that because you don't want them to heal up here. You already see me slightly sweating because I don't know how they are moving. They are moving weird. I would have expected them to move a bit different, and yeah, you kinda need to be good at aiming and reading the enemy movement, and obviously good with your energy management, because that is very important, that you don't use your cloak when you need it the most. For long jump you can make it really hard for them to follow you around, so they most likely won't be able to hunt you down if you go to second wind with this build, because you have long jump. So we don't have to really worry about that, even though they have the fast class. And yeah, what kinda just wanted to do some melee damage, just jump in, make few hits and then jump immediately out. However, the tracking was so bad that it just didn't hit, and even if it would have hit, it would have probably done no damage because the wrist blades are shit. So if you're good with the smart disc, this build will be really good for you, because you can do actually the damage you need here. I kinda went into melee because they really didn't see me, but tracking was bad yet again, and damage is non-existent for the Predator. The fire team can do more melee damage without heavy hitter than the Predator with its wrist blades with fucking fearless equipped, and that's pretty sad. So you don't really want to go into the melee like I did here. You really want to use the smart. This year I lost them out of my eyes, so I called it right back because they were moving away. And here I kinda looked for pigs, where they are located, because they are coming back now. Don't know when I started to play this game, when the new update dropped, there were like no pigs, but now they're returning for some weird reason. I don't know, these pig spawns are really weird. So here I had a slight problem. I forgot I didn't have Divert Lens, what I always use on my Hunter. And since I played Hunter for a bit, this obviously catch me slightly off guard, and they could easily see my laser. There you see some terrible aim of mine. I expected him to move again, but he didn't. And yeah, that's the reason why I did a second build. You can skip to that if you want. I already put the timestamp in, and it's already. It will be again in this description if you missed it somehow. Because you can just skip through for whatever reason to get right to the gameplay. So, anyways, they are now going in there, and I have a problem. Since I'm scout, I can't punish them for that. And they have the medic kit in there that I didn't destroy. I can go with my thingy in, but it won't really help because they nerf the damage so much. They can just move completely to behind. I was kinda drunk because I managed to hit myself with that, and it will happen again. Like I said, first day, first match of the day. Yeah. Like I said, I really sucked at that moment. But the second match will be better. I got a win of that, mostly because I'm way better with the combi stick, even though I didn't really use it. So here, luckily, again some pigs that didn't despawn actually, so I heal myself up. That's what you have to really look on your health, because even though we have faster second wind recovery, we still kinda don't want to lose our possibility of pressuring. Here you see another terrible shot of mine. I decided to go grab my smart disk and proceeded to miss my shots terribly. He's luckily blind. Or, well, I did something slightly smart actually. I hid behind the leaves. Those twigs, those big leaves, because you wanna use them to kinda make it harder for the fire team to spot you or have a clear sight on you with the weapons. And unless they have a sniper, they will miss most of their high damaging shots. So I get it down there, but I can't go for the claim because obviously I will go in second wind. I missed that shot sadly, then I downed him as well. However, look at this damage. I have to move away because if I would have stand still for one more second, I would have died. And here you see the fire team being actually good. One heals now and the other one splits up. I actually wanted to form a smartest there, but I accidentally somehow switched again to my plasma caster. And now I have to heal again because those few shots put me into critical state, and now they are all up again. So this build is more good against noobs if you aren't that good yourself with ranged combat, and you want to use this build only if you're actually really good with ranged combat, with the smart disc, with the bow, if your shots are really accurate. If they don't, my second build will be better for you. You will find more success because we will use the plasma caster instead of the bow, because it's more easier to kill people with a plasma caster than with precise shots from the bow. This guy went somewhat AFK, so I obviously took the time, and he kinda teleported away, and I was like, what the fuck? But anyways, I got my free kill, which will be really helpful because it's easier to deal with just three people. Here I went to collect my arrows because I had like none and I needed them for my pressure. And they are now calling the chopper.
What was that?
Here he just didn't leap. And now I kinda use the AI. The AI is your biggest friend in this chopper situation. You kinda want them to stop shooting at their AI so that there will be more and more over the time and that they down them for you, because you don't have the damage to do that anymore. You can't down them anymore with melee or something. And here I made some terrible shots. But I did what I wanted to do. He isn't looking at the AI anymore. And the AI is shooting him now. Now I go back in. And they have to kinda focus on me and not the AI, because otherwise they will die. That was an AI. So you have to kinda know how the skins look to find out who is AI and who is not. So you shouldn't start with the Klaus if you're with the scout if you're new to the game. And here you always see one got down, the other one just flew up and drops right down. And I got my two long claims. So you really want to use the AI to damage them really hard. However, you also want to get your distance from the AI, because they will obviously shoot at you as well. So this is the build for the people who are not really good with the bow, like me. So instead of the bow, we're using the spear, and a secondary we still use the smart disc. The gear stays the same, however our perks will change. We use energy cell, adrenal boost and devoured lens. Devoured lens will hide our laser, especially at long distances, and this is obviously really good for us. The energy cell is kinda necessary to have enough energy to go move around invisible, cloaked, and at the same time always have the energy for a plasma caster shot. And adrenal boost is always good to have, it's kinda a meta perk. Everyone is running this perk on every class because it's just so good to have better stamina recovery. So in this game I actually won with this build. We had a support, a dodge, an assault and another dodge. Pretty calm and fire teamed. And we were on the same map again. You can already see we kinda suffer from not having the long jump, because we can't move as fast around the map anymore. However, we can still look for the respawn radios, which are again not here anywhere, sadly. They are also not over there as I look for that. So most of the time the fire teams will be at this train station on this map or at the big camp over there. I know that there's another radio spawn, however I don't really have the time, because we need time to pressure them. If we allow them to rush their objectives, we will lose. I mean, we still can use, like in the last match, the AI to get us some downs and kills, however there will be most of the time someone escaping and we don't want anyone to escape. So, as you can see, you can not really see the laser. That's how good it is. And you can always switch between the smart disc and your plasma caster to do the damage necessary. Yeah, I sadly did not get that hit, even though it would be really awesome. And there's someone doing a big mistake. If your fire team never go into a spot where you don't have cover at all sides and no escape available, he had cover on every spring but one side, but because of that cover he couldn't even move away. And another one got downed by the AI, so I'm gonna use that and down him right again. Here I marked another fire team member and kinda got stuck there because invisible walls. I couldn't really throw the spear there because it's scout, you don't have the health. That's what I mean with you can't really win with the scout, because against a really good fire team you will always lose. Because you kinda have to play with big pressure, however you don't have the damage to do that pressure. And you don't have the health either to do long enough the pressure. You can basically, this build is something that you would probably use as well at Hunter or something. However, the only difference is Hunter can do it better than Scout. And this is kinda sad, you have to fight against a fire team which is only average. You can probably win against 20 PC tryhards with this build or with any build for the scout, because scout is just too weak. It's not hard to play the scout, it's just not possible to play the scout because of the broken balancing. So here I threw the spear which hit him and flew right into another dimension. I thought it would have hit the barrel, but it somehow ended up over there. So I used my smartest, but they didn't follow me as I expected them to do. So I got back my stuff and they were separating, which is very stupid. So here I did a mistake. I kinda was ignorant to the message over there. I somehow was able to see the message because I just killed him, which was obviously stupid. But in the end we get more kills of it. So we are lucky that they aren't following us, because here in the water it's kinda risky to eat a pig because you can't cloak. So now they are separating again, which is stupid, but yeah, you can't really win against a fire team that's not separating. With a fire team like this, you have a chance to win. With anything else, you don't really have the chance. I don't know what he threw down there first, because there was no icon. And he somehow managed to damage his teammates more than me. So smartest again, however it was bugged, I wasn't allowed to move it into any other direction for whatever reason. I got one hit and then just jumped right out of there, because the wrist blades are just useless. Melee combat in general is kinda useless with the new patch. And now this AI is revealing my location. I can't eat that pig. And this little bastard is following me, so I will be actually forced to kill the fucking AI, because it just followed me around. And this obviously made noise, so I can't consume the pig because they looked into the direction and saw me. So I kinda have to use my first siren here. What you can also run as perk is medic for faster health regeneration. However, I still would kinda want that energy cell, because it got buffed heavily and it's really useful. Especially if you use the plasma caster with the scout, because you have to stay hidden all the time with invisibility, because otherwise you just get fucked. Because they will always see you. So there were two people in there, so I decided to used that, because he was camping and I just got my replasma shot at that. And that guy was completely missing, just like me. However, I still need to move because his teammate just showed up. And yeah, that's how you kinda play with the scout now. Use melee only, this is a general rule for every predator from the behind, because from behind they can parry you. So that's the only way to actually defeat skilled players in melee combat, otherwise it's not possible. So I checked if he was still in there, however he wasn't, so jump back right over here and they did what I assumed they would do. They will actually hunt me down because they recognized me as a scout. Scout is easy to kill. You can see how much damage I took from that few shots, and all the pigs are over there. And in the water if they're not over there, so I took a risk. Because I knew they were back over there, so they needed to walk a rather huge distance, so I can heal fast enough. And jump right around them. And go back up there. And they kinda give up and just went back to the camp. Because they knew I would just be able to outrun them. Yeah, I actually killed him, which was something I didn't expect. Thought, because the damage is so low, if the predator deals damage, it's actually really surprising. However, I can't really claim him because that would make me immobile. So what you wanna do is, if you want to kill someone, you want to damage them instead of claiming. Because now this guy bleeded out, he's dead, and yeah, only one guy left because all rage quitted. So now it's just a 1v1, you can easily win that. You can either try to go in a 1v1 knife fight. However, he's shooting at me, so I use my ranged combat against him. However, I am trash, so I will miss. Just scored it back, but sadly didn't go up that far. Then I tried it with a combi stick, however I managed to miss that too. And then I kinda gave up and just used my plasma caster. And it's pretty easy with the plasma caster. Because of the splash damage, so I think you need 2 shots for this dodge. 2 body shots were enough. Maybe 3 or 4 with splash damage. However, the splash damage can, unless they fix that, go through walls if they stand close to it. So yeah, this is how you win as the scout. Find a team that's not completely tryhard. And yeah, just pick him off from range, because that's all you can do. You can't do melee combat, especially not with the scout. And yeah, use your mobility to always outrun them. And this is how you win with the scout predator. I will try to upload the last part of the How to Win as Predator series tomorrow with the hunter. And you will see us in my next video. Have a great day.